Special service for this year, the Wulfrun Deanery online carol service. Through this year, all of our churches have had to find new ways of being church, of supporting one another, of worshipping together even when we can't be in the same place, of helping one another to follow our Lord Jesus as his disciples. It seemed good as we head towards Christmas to bring together contributions from almost all of our churches, certainly from all of our benefices and parishes, to prepare us together to welcome our Lord Jesus. You'll find that the service is quite varied in tone, for our churches are very varied in their music, their style, their worship. And it is together that across this deanery, we witness to Christ, born among us afresh this Christmas. So now, what are the traditional biddings? The beginnings to a carol service. My brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome you. We've come together as Christmas draws near to prepare for our celebration of the birth of God's beloved Son. Through the days of Advent, we follow the light of Christ, and now we travel in spirit with Mary and Joseph to Bethlehem to acclaim with the multitude of the heavenly host the coming of the Prince of Peace. Through scripture and silence, prayer and song, let us hear again the wonderful story of our redemption, and hearing, let us rejoice and respond with lively faith. For a moment, we keep silence. We pray, Almighty God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that, as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, we may with sure confidence behold him when he shall come to be our Judge, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah chapter 9, the future king. Nevertheless, there will be no more gloom for those who were in distress. In the past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, but in the future he will honour Galilee by the nations, by the way of the sea beyond the Jordan. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. For to us a child was born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord God Almighty will accomplish this.
Yes. straight into the kingdom of heaven.
So from St. Anne's and from St. Giles in Willenhall, reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20, the shepherds and the angels. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Saviour who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace amongst those whom he favours. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Thanks be to God.
See him lying on a bed of straw, a draughty stable with an open door. Mary cradling the babe she bore, the Prince of Glory is his name. Oh, now carry me to Bethlehem, to see the Lord appear to men. Just as poor as was the stable then, the Prince of Glory when he came. Star of silver, sweep across the skies, show where Jesus in the manger lies. Shepherds, swiftly from your stupor rise, to see the Saviour of the world. Oh, now carry me to Bethlehem, to see the Lord appear to men. Just as poor as was the stable then, the Prince of Glory when he came. Angels, sing again the song you sang, sing the glory of God's gracious plan. Sing that Bethlehem's little baby can be the Saviour of us all. Oh, now carry me to Bethlehem, to see the Lord appear to men. Just as poor as was the sable then, the Prince of Glory when he came. Mine are riches from your poverty, from your innocence eternity. Mine forgiveness by your death for me, child of sorrow for my joy. Oh, now carry me to Bethlehem, to see the Lord appear to men. Just as poor as was the stable then, the Prince of Glory when he came. Oh, now carry me to Bethlehem, to see the Lord appear to men. Just as poor as was the stable then, the Prince of Glory when he came.
Love Came Down at Christmas by Christina Mazzetti. Love came down at Christmas, love all lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas, stars and angels gave the sign. Worship we the Godhead, love incarnate, love divine. Worship we our Jesus, but wherewith for sacred sign. Love shall be our token, love be yours and love be mine. Love to God and all men, love for plea and gift and sign.
A reading from John's Gospel, chapter 1, beginning at verse 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, nor of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth.
Let us prepare our hearts and minds, body and soul, to be inspired. An infant born in lowly state will grow to set our world on fire. He'll spread a light where darkness reigns, revealing all and embracing love. He'll live and die to set us free, pointing the way to heaven above, lighting our way to follow him, spreading his love for one and all, choosing peace where conflict tempts, a helping hand to those who fall. Tiny ember planted deep extinguishes if left alone, yet kindled with the spirit's help, a roaring flame it can become, lighting our way to follow him, spreading his love for one and all, choosing peace where conflict tempts, a helping hand to those who fall. Let's welcome him.
Let's welcome him.
His name is Jesus.
Let's welcome him.
Let's welcome him into our hearts. That glows within us. Let's welcome him into our hearts. Within us, let's welcome him into our hearts.
Let's welcome him.
Let's welcome him.
His name is Jesus.
Let's welcome him.
Let's welcome him
into our hearts.
Kindle the flame.
Kindle the flame that glows within us. Let's welcome him in. Welcome him into our hearts.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. It hardly needs to be said that this has been a very challenging year in the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic. As bad as the virus itself has been, the panic and the anxiety and the fear surrounding it has made the last 12 months an incredibly difficult year for us. And lockdown has certainly been an experience which I don't think any of us are going to forget in a hurry. But now that things are opening up again, looking back, isn't it funny what you miss? I've desperately missed going to sit in a coffee shop, and I miss art galleries and museums. A friend of mine has struggled without his local. Another has found life tough without seeing her grandchildren. Many people, me included, very much miss those little gestures that make us human. Shaking hands, hugging, or popping round for a drink somewhere. But one thing that's been very much brought into my mind over this last year is that old phrase, you don't know what you've got till it's gone. How often did we take those special things for granted from which we have been apart for this last 10 months? And this is true not least for our common life as the church. Many of us have missed bitterly sharing in worship together. Now, online church can be very helpful for many, but I'm sure you will agree that we've recognised and been reminded what a rare and wonderful privilege it is to gather in the Lord's house on the Lord's day and share in the Lord's supper together. And for me, this year has reminded me that we are on the whole tremendously privileged. We are surrounded by so many wonderful gifts from God, which we so often overlook. A few years ago, I did a lot of work with refugees and asylum seekers in Stockport, people who had moved here not to find a better life, but because they'd been forced to flee their homes, mostly in Syria. And I'll never forget spending time with those people who had literally nothing but the clothes on their back. We had a collection at our church for various basic essentials, and the genuine gratitude shown for clean clothes or toothpaste or children's books was completely humbling. We have so much for which to be thankful to our Heavenly Father for. And at this holy time of year, we bring to mind the greatest gift the human race has yet to receive, God's own Son, born amongst us, given freely to us, that he might share in our mortal life. That's a gift which we so often take for granted, a truth which is so often obscured by the daily cares and worries of the world. But it's a wonderful truth, and a truth like no other. The Word became flesh and dwelt amongst us. Now I have two children, Edward, 8, and Rosemary, who's 5, and I love them more than anything. And although sometimes, when it's 2 a.m, and they're jumping up and down on my bed, demanding to pay kaplunk, I would very gladly give them away, most of the time, there's absolutely nothing that I'd give them up for. Nothing. It's inconceivable. And yet God the Father, such is his love for us, takes his only Son and freely gives him to you and I. God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, given to us. And when we look upon the face of the infant Lord, we see a glimpse of the incalculable depth of love God has for us, his children. So much so that he gives us his most precious thing, his Son. Thomas Aquinas likened God's love for us like a furnace burning bright and deep for the human race despite ourselves. Truly, the incarnation is a wonderful, humbling, terrifying, spectacular thing. Now, in the day-to-day stresses and complexities of life, it's easy for us to take what we have for granted. There's nothing surprising about that, it's just human nature. But in the same way, we can so often take for granted all that God does for us and is doing for us. Christmas is a time of joy because we refresh in our minds the wonderful truth of the incarnation and God's everlasting promise to his people. So I ask you to save one of your Christmas cards this year, one with the nativity scene on the front. Pin it up somewhere where you can see it, so that it catches your eye from time to time. And when you notice that card on your mantelpiece or on your wall, that small child which signifies so much joy and goodness and glory and wonder, I hope it might bring to mind again for you the very greatest gift that we have been given, Jesus Christ, God's own Son, born amongst us. I expect that 2021 will be a challenging year in many ways too. So as it unfolds and we continue our pilgrimage of faith together, let us resolve to never take that wonderful truth for granted, and may it continue to illuminate our hearts in 2021 and beyond. Brothers and sisters, in the name of the Church, I invoke upon you peace and joy in the name of our incarnate Lord, and wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Let us pray for the Church and for the world, and thank God for his goodness. As we recall the star that shone out above Bethlehem, we thank you for the gift of your Son, the light of the world. Let us join with people down the ages who have celebrated this event and rejoice. We pray for the Church worldwide at this special time. remembering the places where worship is difficult or dangerous. The places where worship is joyful, but food and resources are scarce. And the places where this festive season is mixed with worries about the future. May your son's birth bring hope to all communities, and may your church be strengthened in its work to make you better known. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, bring a new spirit of cooperation and search for peace in our world. May those who hold the key to progress be encouraged to seek reconciliation and peaceful change. And in our own land, may fairness and justice guide those in local government and national government. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In our prayers, let us remember all those who will be on duty or working over the Christmas period, while we celebrate the birth of your Son. We pray especially for our emergency services and for our hospitals at this difficult time. We pray for our armed forces and for our police, for ships at sea, for charities offering relief to the homeless, and for clergy called to those in need of support. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring to you, Lord, all who are unwell in body, mind, or spirit, and who need your comfort at this time. Remember those known to us who are sick, lonely, or depressed. Help us and all those who are in a caring role to make a difference this Christmas, and to bring some comfort and release to all those who suffer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We remember fondly all those who have died and are now at peace with you. You know, Lord, that the loss of a loved one, recently or long ago, is difficult for us to cope with at Christmas. May the memories we have be a comfort and a support to us. And may the story of Christmas renew our faith in the hope of eternal life. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Many thanks to everyone who has contributed in so many different ways to putting the service together. And thanks to all of you who've done so much in the churches of this deanery. Not only to keep things running, but to keep us serving God together through these last difficult months. May all of you know the peace and the joy of this Christmas, and may God grant us a better 2021. And now may the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Happy Christmas.